Hi, I'm Sanjanak Chowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In this video, I will demonstrate changes to the toolkit when creating a local integration server, so that it can either use a private vault or an external directory vault. I will show that it is now easier to configure a Discovery Connector node like Slack request when using an external directory vault. This capability was added in IBM App Connect Enterprise version 12.0.9. I'll be using a Slack request node, and the integration server will be using an external directory vault. Now, this can all be configured from within the toolkit. The credential that will be added in the vault will be an access token so that the Slack request node can access the Slack service. So I have a clean workspace in my toolkit, and I'm going to start off with creating a local integration server. When launching this wizard in 12.0.9, you'll see some changes from the previous mod releases of ACE. So in this wizard, you can now see that there is an option to access an external directory vault. So this can be used to store your credentials, and an external directory vault can be accessed by several different integration servers. Previously, the wizard allowed you to access a private integration server vault, and that would have been used by individual integration servers for their own private vault. Now you can specify to use an external directory vault, which can be used by different integration servers. If you do want to use a private vault, then you can set the option to do that. So there's a preference. So if I open up my preferences and open up integration development and select vault settings, then there is an option here to use an integration server vault, so that's a private one. So if I select that option and select apply and close, if I now select the option to create a local integration server vault, you can now see that I have the option to either use an external directory vault or a private integration server vault. I'm going to revert back to enabling the setting to not use a private vault, because I want to explain how to use an external directory vault, and it will be clearer by disabling this. So this is disabled by default now. When I create a local integration server, I'm going to create a test server, and I'm going to specify that I want to use an external directory vault. I need to specify a vault key to access the external directory vault, so I'll enter a vault key, and I have to click the button to create the vault. So this will create the external directory vault in my workspace, and I can check that the vault key works, and it does. And in this demo, I'm going to use this integration server for a flow with a Discovery Connector node, so I'm going to use the Slack request node. Prior to 12.09, I would have advised to not start the integration server because you needed to access the credential vault from the node when configuring it. By using an external directory vault, you don't need to do that. You can launch the server so that it is started and the node can still be configured. I'm just going to click finish there, and that will create the integration server, and it will be configured to use the external directory vault. I can see the server started, I can see my external directory vault, and if I open the overrides server conf YAML file for the test server, I can see that as well as it creating the usual HTTP ports for the REST admin listener and the HTTP connector, I can see it's also now added some lines for accessing the external directory vault. Okay, so the external directory vault's been created, the integration service has been started, and it is using the vault. So let's go ahead and create an application. I'll call it Slack app. And I'll create a new flow, and I'll just call it Slack. So I'm going to configure the Slack request node. And you'll see the configuration of this node is now easier. So you still have the launch connector discovery button to launch the discovery wizard. I need to create a policy project, so I'll specify my policy project. I'll call it Slack PP. It has realized that I'm using an external directory vault. It's already got my vault key, which I specified, stored it in my preferences. I can check that I can access the external directory vault. And now I'll just launch the discovery wizard. I'm going to use the select request node to send a message to a channel. And I need to connect to Slack, so I need to specify my access token. And this access token will be stored as a credential in my external directory vault. I can specify that I want to send a message to a channel. And I'm going to send it to a channel called Demo the New Nodes in Ace. I'll click Save. And now the node has been configured. So I'll now just complete the flow by adding a HTTP input and reply nodes so I can send a message to the flow. I'm going to add a mapping so that I can specify what message to send to the first Slack request. In 1209, you can now drag and drop a mapping node over the wire that's connected between the HTTP input and Slack request. And when you open the mapping wizard, it realizes that we have schemas already that have been downloaded from the Slack service, and it is pre-selecting the schema that would be needed for the Slack request node. So it needs the request schema, and it has already selected it for you in the wizard, and I can click Finish. So that's a nice enhancement that has been added in the Ace Toolkit. So it's already using that schema. So I'm just going to add some text to the message that is going to be sent to the channel. And I can put my SSA. Okay, so I have a value that I'm going to send. And save that, and I can save the flow. So the flow is now ready and it is configured. If I deploy the policy project first to my integration server and now send a message to the flow, so I can just send an empty message to the flow. And if I open Slack, I can see that it has sent the message to the channel. So in this video, I've shown that you can now configure the local integration server to use a external directory vault or a private vault. And I've shown that it is now easier to configure the Discovery Connector node, such as the Slack request node, when using the external directory vault. Previously, when you were using a Discovery Connector node with a private integration server vault, you'd need to have stopped the integration server if it was using the private vault. But now, when using the external directory vault, the integration server does not need to be stopped. It can be running and the node can be used.